Hello children, welcome back in my class. Today I'm not just going to teach you any lesson. I just want to share the experience of my dancing career, that how I could be a successful dancer, a successful choreographer, a satisfied dancer and a good teacher. How it could be possible for a long time. As I'm doing choreography and as I took dancing as my career for 10 years, so it's a long time for me. It's a long time to maintain the body, mind and the soul, these three in a complete alignment, in a perfect alignment. So it was not very difficult, but it was not so simple. If you want to pursue such a career like this, where you have to keep your mind active, keep your soul calm to create the things every time in a new way, then definitely there must be some kind of habit in your life, which will definitely help you, which will definitely help you to improve yourself. So what I have inculcated in my life, such a very awesome things, I think so. After passing a decade, I felt like I did well. I did really well. So throughout my experience, I just pass it to you, my children, so that you also can improve yourself if you want to go on such a path like this. If you really want to be such a great dancer, such a good dancer, such a fantastic dancer, such a beautiful dancer, then definitely. So what is the first habit? It definitely that whenever you wake up in the morning, just put a large smile on your face. It definitely going to do a wonder in your life. You are just going to rock. Because we have many reasons to put a smile. And the wonderful reason is that we are alive. So we should do this, because millions of the people didn't wake up today, but you, me and some of the dearest one wake up. Isn't it a wonder? So putting a large smile on a face, it should be our habit. And what I did the second thing in my life is just I always wanted to put all the emotion in the morning aside, because every time emotional ups and downs is not good to maintain a healthy lifestyle. Emotions are essential, but to some extent, not in every extent. So first of all, it's our duty to make us feel calm and cool. And in this way, meditation worked a lot for me. Every day I did it for 20 minutes and it did wonder to me, because the peace is not something beyond that we have to get it after completing our day, after completing a tired full day, then we have to attain the peace. No, peace is something that we should attain it the first at any cost. Peace is something like this. So this is the first priority of our life, that there must be peace in our mind. So I did a lot of meditation in this way, and it really work a lot. So I'm not sharing whatever is overwritten in the books or some kind of scripture. Whatever I just went through, I'm just sharing my experience to you. I'm passing it. Now, the third and the important thing is take care of your body. I feel like body is our temple. Body is our temple. So we have to preserve it. Preserve it, not that you have to take a lot of rest, a lot of sleep. No, not in that way. As much as we use our body in a proper way, it returns a lot to us. So run as much as you can. Involve yourself in physical activity, whatever you want to do. If you are a lover of mountain, then just go and do the climbing. If you want to do the swim, you just swim. Do the cycling, do the aerobic. And if you are not a good dancer, it's not a big deal. Just play the music and just start your body. It means you have to play. You have to play with the system. Then you can only detoxify your body. So do whatever you want to do, but at least involve yourself fully. And the fourth and the very important thing, the morning habit, is whatever you are consuming, whatever the drink you are going through in the morning. What I went through for a long, long time is I'm just going to reveal my secret. It was amla juice, which made me healthy in every situation. It just made me feel very good. So yeah, it tastes definitely bitter, but I liked it because it is a panacea for our stomach, for our eyes. And after consuming this, every time I feel that I'm flying, I'm ready to fly, I'm ready to do anything, whatever comes to my way, I'm just ready to do it. So the first drink, whatever you are consuming, you must notice it, that whatever you are going to serve to your body. And the fifth thing is, what are you going to take as your first diet? Because diet is very important thing and we cannot ignore it. You can't start your morning with a pizza or with a noodles, with Maggi noodles or whatever the last thing nowadays we are serving our body is really very harmful to us. So definitely you have to think about that, which bite you are going to take first. As a dancer, what I experience that the diet which make us feel lethargic, definitely we have to avoid it. It is a misconception that we need much protein and for that we have to go for a non-vegetarian diet. It's just a misconception, because our body needs just 3% of protein, and it is good enough we found in our vegetarian diet. If it is not overcooked, we can consume it by milk, we can consume it by many kinds of fruit, such like bananas and many kinds of sprouts. They are the good source of protein. Okay, So we just can go through and can get the 3% of protein, because you must know that protein doesn't make the strength. Because for a flexible body, we have to consume a lot of water. Okay, we can't depend on a flesh diet. It is definitely not going to work. So being a vegetarian family, since I belong to a vegetarian family, I just feel very fortunate that I have never been through that lethargic kind of diet, and I always felt like very light, that it made me help a lot. So I'm just passing my experience to you, and I hope that if you include these tips in your life, then definitely you are just going to comment that, ma'am, it's really worked a lot for me. You will really feel good, and then definitely I will feel very good, because I just want to serve the quality to the world.